गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग बेटा। चिल्ड्रन प्लीज ओपन योर कैमरास। रणशेर एंड रुद्र विक्रम सिंह ओपन योर कैमरास। Okay, Rotu, you were not there yesterday. In yesterday's class, were you there? All right. So we did lesson 1. Koala le flair, frère et le sœur de Manuel. Any problem in the chapter? Yes. Any problem, children? No.
No.
That's fine. Wonderful. Now what you will do today is we will do the body parts. The body parts that are shown here on page number 15. Now what are body parts called? How do we say it in French? That's called les parties du corps. The parts of the body, les parties du corps. Who will read them out? Yes, who will read them out? Tell me. See, I have written, I have sent in the chat box, les parties du corps. That means the parts of the body. Now, starting from head to toe, they have mentioned, they have described or labeled all the parts separately. So, what is the head called? The head is called la tête. What is it called? Everybody will repeat after me.
La tête.
La tête. Pranjali Dikshit, Rudra
Vikram.
Yes. Then the neck. Neck is called le cou. Le cou.
Le cou.
Very nice. Then the chest is called la poitrine. La poitrine. What is it called? Yes, what is it called?
La
poitrine. Then, stomach. Stomach is called l'estomac or le ventre. L'estomac or le ventre.
Le ventre.
Then, hands. The hands are called le main. Le main. And when we talk about both the hands, we say les mains. Okay? Then the knee area. Knee is called genou. Le genou.
Le genou.
And the foot. The foot is le pied. Le pied. The toes. Toes are called les orteils. Les orteils. Sorry. Les orteils. And what they have written in bracket, when they have written M in bracket, that means when we talk about a single toe, that is masculine. M stands for masculine here. Okay. Similarly, lestoma is what? Masculine. Clear? Now, next we have the hair. I told you yesterday also, it's leshavo. Leshavo. Shoulders. The shoulders are called lepole. The shoulder is lepole, and when we say the shoulders, we say lezepole. Then the arm area is called lega. The back is called la hanche. Then the fingers, fingers are called les doigts. Then the thigh area is called la cuisse. The leg is called la jambe. Particularly the thigh area, la cuisse, the whole leg is called la jambe. Now what you will do is using a few adjectives, right? Using a few adjectives, you have to frame small sentences using all these body parts. Is that clear? Like suppose for head. Now for head, what kind of a sentence can you make? Now see, head is what? Head is feminine gender. Is that clear? Now what kind of a sentence can be made using the word head? Tell me. Something easy that you can frame on your own. Okay, first of all, see, let me tell you one thing. If suppose you want to say, I have pain. Suppose I have headache, I have stomachache or anything. What do you say? J mal. That means I have pain. Now, depends. The body part is masculine or it is feminine. If suppose you have pain in your head, you will say J mal a la tête. Children, in laptop, the accents are missing. So please ignore that part. Okay? Only on phone I can send you with accent. J mal a la tête means I have headache. Right? Why? Because head is feminine gender. Now, if I want to say, if I talk about my stomach. Stomach is what? Look into the book. What gender it is? What gender it is?
Masculine.
So before masculine, we do not use ala. What do we use? We use o. Je mal o ventre. Okay? Now this is like I have pain. I have stomachache. I have headache. Now similarly, like because you did not, you have not done this pain, so I told you this part. To have the expression to show pain anywhere. The expression is je mal. Fine? Now what you'll do is you will use simple adjectives that we have done. Like for shoulders, you can say narrow or broad like that. The head is big. The arms are strong. Strong we did yesterday only. Right? The legs are long. Anything like that, please start doing in your copies. Start doing in your French copy this work. And children, please open your cameras. Pranjali Dikshit, open your camera. Okay, tell me what sentence are you going to make for the neck? Children, just think in English, what are you going to make?
My neck is long, very long.
Very nice. My neck is long, or you can also say a long neck looks beautiful. A long neck is beautiful, isn't it?
Yes.
So what is long? What is the word for long? It's long only, L-O-N-G only. Then, la poitrine. What sentence are you going to make for chest? Can we make he has a broad chest? Come on, boys, tell me for chest, which player or which wrestler or anybody who has a broad chest? Tell me. Frame a sentence like that.
My friend has a broad chest.
All right. So, how will you make it? What is the word for broad? The word for broad is large. L-A-R-G-E. Large.
Okay.
And for what are you going to use for my friend? Tell me. My friend is... Mon ami a une large poitrine. My friend has a broad chest. Children, after doing this work, you have to post this work on the class group. Is that clear? Everybody will show me what sentence you have made. And I really cannot see that you people are making sentences. Why do I feel that you're just sitting idle? You've got no questions, nothing. Pranjali, are you doing the work? Pranjali is not even connected to audio. Ranshir, beta, what about you?
Yes, ma'am, doing one.
How many have you framed? How many sentences have you made? Ranshir, beta, how much have you done? Ranshir? Ranshir, have you done it, beta? I think nobody is there in the class, which means that I should end the meeting.